मन की ये भाषा, यहाँ दो दो है आशा, यही मोदी यही योगी उपयोगी।
वेट अ मिनट, ये सुना सुना नहीं लग रहा। स्नैपी हैशटैग्स, पेपी ट्यून्स, स्पिरिटेड स्लोगन्स, India's very own political parties are once again all over social media, pitching to their voters with great vigor and liveliness as five states go to elections in February 2022. The poll campaigns went virtual in view of the third wave of the coronavirus pandemic. With the banning of physical rallies till January 22nd, political parties have taken a musical route to lift the mood of supporters, praise their leaders, and promote their policies and ideologies. From songs of BJP that highlight the construction of Ram Temple in Ayodhya under the Yogi Adityanath government, to Trinamool Congress's attempt to launch a Konkani song that would cater to the local vote bank of Goa, political parties have left no stone unturned to woo their electorate. It was all fun and games till these parties were only pleading for votes. But ye India hai janab, agar masala na ho to fika lagta hai. Political parties cranked it up a notch by delivering punches and counter punches to their opponents in their bid to reach out to the voters.
गोरखपुर में खून से रंगल गोतल पूरा खाके बार काबा, यूपी में काबा।
बी एच समाजवादी पार्टी खड़ेरा हुई बे और कांग्रेस तीन तिगाड़ा काम बिगाड़ा।
उत्तराखंड में नहीं आएगी भाजपा दोबारा।
All the songs target the ruling party, their biggest opponent in UP, the BJP. Meanwhile, Aam Aadmi Party tried a different approach and posted a meme that had images of Punjab's Chief Minister Charanjit Singh Channi and Rahul Gandhi superimposed in the video. This was their style to introduce their Chief Ministerial candidate, Sardar Bhagwant Mann. The party also hit out at Channi, who has been announcing SOPs since assuming office by portraying him as Elan Mantri in a comic strip. But what issues do these songs address? Are they as long, winding and academic as politicians' on-field speeches generally are? Nope. The songs cater to issues like unemployed youth, farmers, labourers, education and involvement of women in mainstream politics. These songs make an attempt to drive home development, goals and more through peppy, catchy beats. Something that's easier to consume than long speeches of winding pamphlets. After all, this is why songs are crucial even during elections, right? More often than not, they do the job of capturing the right note in the hearts and minds of the voters.